So the setting is the Truth Matters Conference, an evangelical conference dedicated to lying. The theme is the sufficiency of Scripture, or why none of the other books count. And the speaker was John MacArthur, pastor and longtime host of the Grace to You radio show. So you know we're about to get some crazy progressive thoughts on the role of women in society, right? So during a panel, the moderator decides to play a fun word association game and calls on everybody to respond to various subjects in two words. John MacArthur's subject was Beth Moore. And obviously, if you or I got that subject, our two-word reply would be, the fuck's that? But a guy like John MacArthur knows exactly who the moderator was asking about. She's the founder of Living Proof Ministries, which is a ministry that focuses on aiding women. And nothing pisses evangelical men off like aiding women. So his two-word response was, go home. The audience clapped because what kind of awful fucks would pay to go to something like this to begin with? But to make it clear that he wasn't just disparaging her as a human being, he went on to complain that, quote, the church is caving in to women preachers, end quote, before launching into a tirade about the evils of the Me Too movement. So yeah, his argument is that evangelical Christians, i.e. the people currently in your audience cheering wildly at every misogynistic brain turd you utter, are getting too feminist. But enough bad news. Let's move on to some good news I missed at the beginning of the month. Northern Ireland is set to move into last century with its abortion laws now that their high court has ruled that their current laws contravene UK human rights laws. This ruling stemmed from a case where a woman in Northern Ireland was being denied an abortion even after multiple doctors concluded that her fetus wasn't viable. So she had to go to London to terminate her pregnancy. A quick jaunt of 500 miles and the IRC. So to be clear, they're not exactly going to become civilized or anything. Their current law allows for abortion only when there's a serious risk to the women's physical or mental health. And apparently they don't consider being forced to bear the child of rape to be a risk to her mental health. Nor are cases where the baby will die shortly after birth. It's very important to pro-life people that those babies suffer, you see. And as bad as all of that is, the only thing set to change is that last one. So no soup for Ireland, but they're at least allowed to smell other people's soup now. And lastly, I want to thank Lucas Gauthier, sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name, and his friend Annie, who made my week by trolling the shit out of Kevin Sorbo. See, K-Sorbs has this thing where you can pay him $50 and he'll record a happy birthday message or a congratulations or whatever the fuck you want him to say. He needs the money. So Lucas gave him $50 and asked him to congratulate Annie on her recent abortion. In the message, he said, quote, it was the abortion we had together. It was my baby. We are both very excited that it got sucked out a science tube. End quote. Well, in order to turn the money down on principle, you'd have to have principles. So K-Sorbs took their money and sent them this preachy video about the horrors of abortion, which included the line, quote, if this is funny for you guys, whatever. Kind of a sick way to be funny, but it does make me sad. It does. End quote. And don't get me wrong. It is funny. It's fucking hilarious. But even if it wasn't, I'm pretty sure the fact that you're sad made it worth Lucas's $50. Because you're not just the butt of the joke. You're also a horrible, terrible person. And on that note, I'll hand things back over to Noah, Heath, and Eli.